What the hell's been going on here? I can already see a burning car.
Look at that. Ride a great tanker on its side.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra One.
Go ahead.
We're at the RTA at Cheetham Road now, Sarge. And there's more struggling vehicles involved than some sort of tanker.
Yeah, received. The fire service and the ambulance service are on their way, Dave. Do you want any further assistance?
Yes, we will, Sarge.
But it's mine, I've got to sort it.
It's that over there, okay?
Is there anybody in there? Did you see anybody get out of the van?
No, he got out.
You sure?
Yeah, he got
out. Keep away from your vehicle, all right?
I'll put that one out, David.
You stay away from it.
I'm going to check the tanker driver.
What?
Oh. Hello. Can you hear me? What's your name? Look, make a noise if you can hear me. Anything. That's good. I just need to see the damage.
Right?
Right. You're going to be okay. Keep talking to him.
It's not good.
His legs are trapped, right? If we lift him, we might be able to get him clear.
Well, if the gate's on its way, we'll leave it to them.
Well, come on, Big Tone. That stuff you want to put down on him once. It's not going to take too much time to settle the rest.
I'm more worried about this.
What, it stinks, what is it?
No idea. There's no markings. Best thing we can do is keep out of it. Let the brigade sort it.
I'll see if there's a trench guard in his camp.
Okay, I'll go brief the paramedic.
Right, you two, get out of it, quick. Quick as you can, move it. Look, this is important. We need...
Need a hand, Dave?
No, Carl, look, the driver's well out of it. You best keep well clear.
What's this thing?
Look, there's a spill and I don't know what it is. Go to the tube station and stop them letting anybody else out, okay?
Right.
One of the witnesses reckons that he saw the van driver clear. Check to see if he's okay.
Right.
Thank you. Just move back for me.
Right.
You okay, mate?
My head hurts like crazy. My throat's sore.
Right.
Yeah, over here, please.
Right, it's burning.
Right, can you tell me what vehicle you're in?
Yeah, the van was left of it.
You all right?
Yeah, I think so. Good.
Pixie Quinnan, Special Officer Carey. Right, we've got one casualty, he's in the cab of the tanker.
Right.
Adam, you and Gordon set up a restricted area, I'll have a recce.
That scaffolding looks no too stable.
No, look, we've got a spill, it's causing some sort of fumes.
Right.
Over the other side, scaffolding's falling all around, may have damaged the shell.
Any idea what he's got on board?
Well, there's no Haskin markings and I couldn't see a trench guard in his cab.
Have you asked the driver?
No chance, I couldn't even get his name out of him.
Brilliant, and I suppose the UN number's out of the question.
Right.
All right, until we know what we're dealing with, I want this immediate area isolated.
Right, I'll get this lot reversed and gone.
No time for that, get their engines switched off and get the drivers out of here, fast.
Right. Can you turn it off, mate? Just leave the vehicle there and go down the corner road, please. Can you all move right back to behind that corner, please, for safety before I move back? Turn it off, mate. Get all your passengers out, will you? Go around the back of that corner there.
Can't talk, Tony. These always happen on a bus route.
We only want the whole area clear, sir. The tanker's leaking.
Right, take Martin and Barry to help this end. Thank Trevor, you. Get up the top. Block the road, yeah? Nobody's to come through. Understood? Yep.
Station Officer Carey.
Now, what's the situation?
Chemical spill, no marking. So as yet, we can't estimate what the toxicity is. Of course, the driver should have a load of paperwork in his cab.
Only don't bet on it.
Yeah, absolutely. Cowboys. Seen enough of them. Anyway, I've put a call out. Brigade scientific advisors on the way.
How can we help?
Well, until I know for certain, I'm assuming the worst. I'd like these flats cleared and I'd like all residential windows closed.
June, I want us to get these flats evacuated and I think we better close the tube station as well, okay?
I'm setting up a contamination area, right? I think it's important that this spill, whatever it is contained. Hey, and it'd help if that bloody joker who put this lot on the road could tell us what it is he's carrying.
Matthew. Sierra Oscar 7-0 receiving.
Go ahead, mate.
Yeah, can I have a vehicle check, please, Bob? It's a tanker. Registration. Hang on a sec, I can't quite see it. Victor X-ray Hotel. 1-5-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6
going on. All I care about is whether my car's alright.
Okay, take it easy. The main thing is you're not hurt, yeah?
It just happened so quickly. I mean, my car got shunted in.
Oh, sorry. All right. Just relax, okay? Just straight back. Sitting here, I'll get a paramedic over to you, okay?
The next thing we need to do is get everybody out of these flats, all right? No arguments, and hurry them along. You take the ground floor, I'll go upstairs.
Gentlemen.
Yes.
Dave.
Malachi, new reporting officer.
Right, so Tony's checked most of the vehicles, and I'm sorting the witnesses now.
Okay, carry on.
Hey. What's the score?
Some sort of inhalation problem.
He was driving the van, yeah?
Yeah. Name's Spinks. I can let you have his details.
Well, thanks. So I'll have a quick word with him.
Yeah, but make it quick, okay?
Right, Mr. Spinks, please see Quinn. Just take us into the back of the ambulance, yeah? Right, I need to ask you exactly what you saw. What did you see at the accident?
I parked up near the tube. I pulled out, got to the corner, and I saw this tanker coming hurtling towards me.
All right, just take it easy.
Breathe easy.
Just take it easy. Look, don't worry, I need to take a formal statement later, okay? Just make sure it's all right, yeah? Mr. Carey? Aaron, we go in and get the tanker driver out.
Well, as soon as we can, but it might take a bit of a while because we've got to use the hand cutters. I can't risk a spark setting the whole lot up.
One of the casualties is having breathing difficulties. Could that be down to the spill?
If I knew that, I'd tell you, wouldn't I? I'm sorry.
Yes.
Inspector?
Yeah.
Now, we managed to work out what caused the spill. It's the valve groove. It's ruptured.
I see. Is there any way of slowing it down?
Well, we'll try. We've got the casualty out. We'll try and stop the leaks, but the main problem is, you know, we've already got a lot of seepage into the sewers.
I see.
Yeah, we'll do what we can, but we're definitely going to have to get main drainage down here.
Get on to it. How about that chemical? Are we any nearer to identifying it?
Well, it's corrosive, we know that. Apart from that, we're operating blind.
Right.
I don't like that bloody scaffolding either. I want to get my crew out from under that.
The gate scientific advisor's here, do you want to have a word?
Oh, great. Well, we might find something out now.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 1,
sir.
Tank is registered to a JYB haulage. Got an office on the industrial estate.
Right, hang on, Bob. Matt, see if you can find out someone in charge. We've got to find out what the tank had on board exactly. Not just a rough approximation, yeah?
Yeah, Bob, can we get on to main drainage? Get some of their people down here.
Exactly. We expect it to come.
Not that way. Can you come away, please? Well away from the interface.
What's with all that? What do they need them for?
Come on, sir. It's only a precaution.
You think we're daft? What the hell was he carrying?
Oh, let's not worry about that for a minute, eh?
Well, it's all right for you. You don't have to live here. How many times have I complained about lorries using this as a rat run? Been a death trap for ages. Yeah.
Just lighter if you don't mind, sir.
It's a bit lit already.
Make yourself known to an officer. Thank you. No problems.
He should be grateful he's well away from it. I don't suppose we'll be so lucky.
No. We've had to block the road up, there's been a bit of a serious accident. If you do us a favour and find another route. Yeah, thanks for the understanding.
I'm trying to trace a vehicle, I think it's one of yours.
Not mine, I just check them in and out.
Well, it's an ERF tanker, registration BXH156B.
Yeah, well, that's out of this yard. What's he done? Parked on a double yellow?
We need to know what he was carrying. Where would I find that?
That'd be on the job sheet.
Well, where's that?
You, Archie? In the office. But I ain't got a key.
You haven't got a key? You're security, ain't you?
I just look after the gate, pal. Stop people messing about with the lorries. Mr. Drew locks everything up over there.
Was anyone else got a key? Another employee, secretary?
A few times she's been here before him. She's had to wait on the doorstep for Drew to open up. He don't trust nobody if he can help it.
We're going to find this Mr. Drew.
What day is it? Try the Phoenix, have it a boxing. Loves a good bust up.
Hang on a sec. bloke that was driving tonight. Do you know his name? Well, you're on the gate. You must know who's in and out.
It was a new face. Dan something. Lawson. I think that's what he said.
Thanks for all your help.
I've got an alternative location for the owner. I'm checking that now.
Receive, Matt. Keep me informed.
Gentlemen, driver's name's believed to be Daniel Lawson. Stay with him, right?
Right, sir.
Okay, let's move it. You with us?
Yeah.
Well, I don't think he's going to do much talking.
How bad is he?
Not much as you would expect. Looks like internal injuries to me. Not looking too clever.
1, 2, 3. Hey. What?
All right. I'll tell you one thing, dear lecturer. He should have a whiff of his breath.
What, drink?
Well, either that or he's got a big thing for wine gums. Mr. True?
Yeah?
Can I have a word?
Hey, I could do with seeing the rest of this. I'm sponsoring one of these lads. He's a good fighter.
Really? Over here, please.
All right, what can I do for you?
Tanker, registration VXH156V.
Yeah, I own it. Why?
Mr. Drew, there's been an accident.
This I could do without. How bad?
Went into some scaffolding. There's been a spillage. We need to know what chemicals were on board.
I have to look it up in the office.
You got no idea? This is urgent.
Well, I don't keep that sort of stuff, me. Come on, then.
For your information, sir, one of the paramedics suspects that the casualty may have been drinking.
Can we get that confirmed one way or another?
No, that's not possible, sir, and the casualty's condition's too serious.
Here we go.
Can you stand by, please?
Have we got a name?
We believe he's a Daniel Lawson. He's been trapped in the cab of his tanker.
For how long?
15, 20 minutes.
Okay, everyone, clocks on. What have we got?
Severe chest injuries, query pneumothorax.
Cut his shirt off. Check for bilateral air entry.
After three.
1, 2, 3.
Put another line in. And put the monitor on. Do blood pressure.
Have you contacted the next of kin?
No, not yet.
I think you'd better not hang around.
Right.
Sierra Oscar 1 from 643 receiving.
Go ahead, June. I'm still here.
I'm at St. Hugh's now, sir. Mr. Lawson's in resus. He's still unconscious.
Understood. Wait with him, June.
Yes, sir. I don't think we're going to get anything out of him, though. From what the doctors are saying, they don't hold out much hope.
Right, keep me informed.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 1. Did you get that, Bob?
All received. You want me to get on to the traffic garage, get an AI out?
Yes, I'll sort it this end. But until we know different, I'm treating this as a FATAC. Understood?
Everybody back!
Not bad. Must be making a fair living.
Bad choice of words, Gary. Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm WPC Data. This is PC McCann, Sun Hill. I wonder if we could come in for a minute.
Well, what is it?
You are?
Odette Lawson.
Are you related to a Daniel Lawson?
I'm married to him, yes. What is all this?
It might be better if we came inside to talk.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Lawson, we think your husband may have been involved in an accident.
No?
At this stage, we can't be certain it's him.
Was your husband out driving a tank tonight for JYB haulage?
Yes, that's right.
Well, a tanker was involved in a collision. The driver's been taken to hospital.
I see.
We can't be sure how serious it is.
Obviously, the hospital will be able to tell you more.
Yes, of course. I'll go down there. I just need to sort a few things out here first. No, you're right. I should go down to the hospital to be with him. I'll just get my car keys.
Mrs. Lawson, perhaps it'd be better if we took you.
Is there someone we can fetch? A friend, perhaps? Or is there someone else in the house who might like to come along with you?
No.
How about a neighbour? I could pop round.
No, thank you. Excuse me.
Mrs. Lawson, are you okay?
I'm sorry. Just finding it hard to take it in. I've always feared something like this, you know. Every time it goes off, I expect the worst. It's almost a relief when it does happen.
Fond of security, are you?
Commercial interest, Sergeant. This trade's cutthroat. You let anyone know what you got on the beam.
Yeah?
End up with empty lorries stuck in Carlisle while the load they're supposed to be collecting's already halfway down the M1.
Let's look at the job sheet, shall we?
Oh, have you got no better to do, Mickey?
Here we are. Well, it should be in here somewhere. What do you call this?
Creative filing.
Well, I'll get busy. Job comes in, you're sorted. Sometimes things get left.
Like not marking up your tanker properly. Would have saved a lot of hassle.
Well, that's down to the depot manager the other end. I always tell my drivers never to go without a full markings. Right. There you are.
Sodium hypochlorite?
Aye, some sort of bleach, I think they said. Something to do with cleaning.
Don't sound too sure.
Well, transport the stuff from A to B. As long as it's legit, that's all I ask.
That's good enough for the health and safety, is it?
Hey, what's any of this got to do with the health and safety? I thought it was just some pissant little accident.
If you say so. Sierra Oscar 1 from 7i receiving.
Go ahead, Matthew.
Yeah, I'm at the haulage company now, sir. The chemical the tanker was carrying is sodium hypochlorite. Only Mr. Drew's a little bit vague about what it does.
Well, that's helpful. Okay, all received. We think we've got a trace on this stuff. Sodium hypochlorite?
Yes, that tallies with what I'm getting.
Inspector Munro, Amir Khan, the scientific advisor.
So, what are we looking at, Mr. Khan?
It's chlorine-based. That's the smell. Used in industry to control bacteria in pipes, that sort of thing.
How hazardous is it?
Highly. Its vapours are highly irritant to the lungs and skin.
The spray will keep it down, stop it spreading.
Tell me, Inspector, did any of your men approach the spill without protective clothing?
Well, my officers were first on the scene, yes. Are you telling me they've been exposed
to
something?
I'm sure there's no cause for alarm. All I'm suggesting is that we undertake a few precautions.
Right, fast time, girls and boys. Don't forget behind your ears.
Well, can't I just put a uniform through the laundry, sir?
Sorry, Dave, you four were first on the scene. Now, there's every chance your clothes were contaminated.
Over there, son, we'll sort you out. Hey, one of my team picked up one of your radios. Something about that driver being pissed up.
There's nothing definite as yet.
Yeah, but it's a possibility. And he's driving around with a load like that.
We had to do something.
All right, any last requests?
Let's just get it over with, can we?
Let him have it, lads.
Funny,
you lot later.
Well.
Inspector Munro, PC Galley, Accident Investigation Unit.
All right, sorry to drag you out.
I've had an initial briefing. I take it none of these vehicles have been moved?
No, it's more or less preserved as was.
Good, thank you, sir. I'll get started.
Back behind the lines, please, sir.
It's all right. Look, I'm from JYB Haulage. That's one of our lorries.
Sorry, you sir. Can... Do as my officer says, please, for your own safety.
I'm only have to have a look.
Yeah, but not now.
Crying out loud, it's my tanker.
You are?
He reckons he's from the Haulage Company, sir.
Gavin Drew.
I see.
All I know so far is what you were sergeant told us. I wanted to see myself what the damage was.
Well, that's understandable, but right now we have a job to do.
Look, it's my vehicle. I've got a right to see.
Let him go.
Satisfied? As you can see, we're dealing with a serious situation here, Mr. Drew.
Meaning what? Is all this really necessary?
Yes, it is. We have a major chemical spill, possible contamination of the main drain system, added to which your driver is currently in a critical condition in hospital. And now, perhaps you'll let us get on with the job.
Come on now, sir.
June, this is Mrs. Lawson.
Hello, I'm WPC. I'm afraid we don't have any more news on your husband yet, but obviously they'll let us know as soon as they do.
Yes, I understand.
I'll leave you now, Mrs. Lawson.
Yes,
thank you.
Thank you.
Were you there at the accident?
Yes, I was with your husband in the ambulance.
Did he say anything?
No, I'm afraid that by the time they got him out, he was already unconscious.
I see.
I mean, everybody in there is doing all they can to help him, and the fire crew put themselves at great risk to get him out.
Oh, yes, I'm very grateful. To everyone.
Shall we go and wait up there?
Spare of everything in my locker, Dave, if you
want to
borrow anything.
Yeah, I don't want to joke,
so. You all right?
Oh, probably just the leftovers of me cold. Mind you, getting pelted with freezing cold water didn't help.
Well, that's the glamour of the job, Paul. Oh. Anyway, Chief Inspector Conway wants you four checked over at St. Hugh's. Have you got any sense to fill out a 438? Eight. Could be in for a nice early night.
Tanker's been drained. Scene is now clear. Fire brigade are pulling out.
611, we've got 230, please. Yes, sir. How's it going?
Getting there, sir. Putting the picture together slowly.
Hey, you wanted this. From the cab.
Thanks. Where was it found?
Not in the tachograph. Under the passenger seat. Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Bye.
Part of the course, sir. Either dump the disc or cut the wires. Quick way to add a few more hours to the working day.
Yes.
Can I show you something, sir?
What am I looking for?
Tyre marks from the tanker. When a vehicle brakes, it leaves tread on the road surface, especially when it's braking sharply.
I can't see anything.
Nor can I.
Meaning?
Well, I can't be sure yet, sir. There's a long way to go, but so far I can find no evidence of the tanker braking as it approaches the bend. It was out of control.
A mechanical failure?
It's unlikely. It's always possible there was a massive fault with the braking system, but I doubt it. My money's on that the brakes were never applied in the first place.
You're saying it's possible that the driver made no effort to stop his vehicle?
For whatever reason, yes, sir. It's beginning to look that way.
Paul?
Excuse me. What are you doing here?
We all got sent down to get checked over. The doctor reckons I'm fine.
Good.
Is that the driver's wife?
Yeah.
Could I have a word?
Certainly. Would you mind sitting with me?
Of course.
I'll go to the office.
Mm-hmm. I'm afraid it's as we expected.
Right.
Mr. Lawson was pronounced dead at 12:03. He never regained consciousness. Not too surprising, a man in his condition.
How do you mean?
Well, this is all off the record. Anything official?
Yeah, I know. Has to wait for the PM.
We took a sample of blood. That's standard for cross-matching. Mr. Lawson showed a high level of alcohol present.
Right, so he was drunk?
Yes and no. Probably not so you'd have noticed.
Sorry?
Well, my guess is that Mr. Lawson was a chronic alcoholic. As such, his ability to cope with larger doses of alcohol would have been finely honed. In many ways, he would have seemed perfectly normal. Give or take the odd lapse of concentration. The accident, for instance.
Are you sure about this? I mean, he's got a job driving heavy vehicles.
He had to conduct invasive surgery. I'll spare you the details, but yes, I'm sure.
Any units deal? JYB Haulage,
Elcott Street, burglary. Suspect believed on premises.
Sierra Oscar 79 receiving.
Yeah, I got that, Matthew.
Yeah, Bob, that haulage company, can you check the location? I was there earlier.
Yeah, it's JYB Haulage, Elcott Street.
Informant of Mickey Weller.
Right, can you show me dealing, please?
There's no easy way of saying this, Mrs. Lawson. I'm afraid your husband died just after midnight. We did everything we could. I'm sorry.
Are you all right, Mrs. Lawson?
Yes. Well, that's that then.
Banging. I just guessed.
Boy, you didn't have a look.
No need. I knew it was nobody that was supposed to be there, so I rang you lot.
Very brave.
Oh, you think it's worth getting clobbered for what I earn, do you?
Threatened to come down here, yeah?
Yeah, well, I came out by the gate and I saw a bloke ducked down by the fence.
What, on his own?
Well, I never saw anyone else. But that's not to say there weren't more down here, though.
How long's that been there, then?
Don't know.
Right, let's go and see what they took.
If you can give the nursing staff a few minutes, they'll fetch Mrs. Lawson when they're ready.
Yeah, of course.
Are you all right, Odette? Is there anything you'd like me to get you?
No. What happens next? We'll need you to formally identify your husband's body. Then there'll be a post-mortem.
That's nothing to be concerned about.
What about the body? What happens? As soon as we can, we'll release it to you for burial.
I see.
And how about telling people?
How do you mean?
About him dying. Do you have to inform other people, or do you leave that to me?
Well, if you'd like us to tell anyone.
No, I'd like to do that myself.
If that's what you prefer.
Oh, and his things. I'd like his things, please.
Well, it's messy enough to be kids. Any idea what's gone?
Yeah, go ask Drew.
Has he got a safe?
Yeah, it's down there.
All right, come on in. Well, they didn't see or they didn't fancy it. What's this? Petty cash?
Yeah. Drew gets his secretary to give me money out of it. Fetch milk on it.
That's definitely not kids. They'd have been more thorough. What's all this then?
Oh, job sheets go back ages.
How long you work for Drew, Mickey?
Well, since he came to the yard. He used to work with his old man before that, driving.
Long time then?
Yeah, it's a different game then, though.
How do you mean?
Well, just different. All his stuff went on, it was things he could handle.
Now the stuff you're not keen on?
One of our lads went by Cheatham Road. He reckoned it'd be a miracle if our driver got out of that smash.
Why the sudden concern? I thought you hardly knew him.
Well, just asking.
Oh, you're right, Mickey. It would have been a miracle. Of course, he would have stood a chance if the tank was properly marked. We'd have got to him quicker. Is that the kind of thing you're not keen on?
Oh, no. I'm not getting involved.
Mickey, you are involved. Earlier you said you hardly knew Dan Lawson. According to these sheets, he's worked for this yard for quite a time. Here you go, May 94. Milford Haven, Swansea, Holyhead. What's going on?
All I said was, It was a new face to me.
I've just spoken to the nursing staff. They're still getting your husband's effects together. It won't be long.
Thank you.
Did he always drive?
More or less. Had his own yard for a while. There was never much good behind a desk.
What happened?
He lost it. How much longer is this going to take, do you think?
I don't know. Do you want me to fetch someone to wait with you?
No. I just want to get this over and done with. See him and go home.
You as being all right.
What do you mean?
The way she's taking all this.
Come on, Polly. I mean, put yourself in her position, you would make a lot of sense.
Well, maybe so, but she hasn't mentioned her husband's name once. It's always him, his things.
You're saying she's hiding something? Yeah, well, you're right. Her husband was a drunk. Probably gave her a hell of a time. Not something you'd want to shout about in the circumstances. I wonder if I could have a word, in private, perhaps?
My charge nurse was putting Mr. Lawson's effects together. I understand Mrs. Lawson wants to take them away with her.
That's right.
Well, I thought before she did, you ought to see this.
William Bell?
There's a gas bill in there in the same name.
Odette, I'm sorry, but I have to ask you formally. Is this your husband?
Yes, that's him.
If you'd like to touch him, hold him, be on your own with him for a while.
No.
Look, Odette, it may help to talk about him if you...
There's not much to say, really. He was a good husband, worked hard, always looked after me.
I'm just saying it's best not to lock things in.
I'm not locking things in. I'm just trying to get through this. Look, I've identified my husband. That's the lot, isn't it? Now I'd like to go home, please.
Yes, of course. Sir, ask him 643.
Go ahead, June.
Yes, can we get transport, please?
Where was it found?
In the casualty's clothing.
And Mrs. Lawson formally identified the body as that of her husband?
Yes, Sarge.
Sarge, there's a Mr. Drew in reception with his solicitor. You free to deal?
Yeah, I'll deal. Debs, is Dave Cunningham back from the hospital yet?
Yeah, he's writing up his ARBs in the canteen.
Right. Check these out with DIO. Anything you can get on William Bell.
Right.
Would you like us to come in, then?
No, I'm fine. I'm used to being on my own.
Your car's gone.
What? Oh, yes, it's not mine.
Are you sure you're going to be all right, Odette?
What's this, Mr. Drew? A preemptive strike?
Just want to get things sorted out, that's all.
This is quite unnecessary, Sergeant. My client attended the scene of the accident this evening. Apparently the tone of the inspector was in some part accusatory.
What's going on, Sarge?
I think we're about to find out.
Mr. Drew is keen to cooperate fully with the police on any matters arising. With that in mind, as you can see, the vehicle was fully checked less than 2 months ago. Found to be perfectly roadworthy.
All right now, Mr. Darnell, I'm more interested in the driver your client put behind the wheel.
We'd anticipated that. Mr. Drew is a responsible employer, Sergeant. In addition to all of his drivers having held a clean C&E license for at least 2 years, he insists on a full medical certificate. Mr. Lawson was granted a clean bill of health prior to being taken on.
Sudden change of heart. A couple of hours ago, this was one big hassle for you.
Look, I don't deserve this. All I've had so far is snide comments. Haulage is a hard trade, but I built that business up. I employ people.
Thought the business belonged to your father?
Should have seen the state it was in when I took it over. Somebody needed to turn it round, give it an edge.
Is that what the lorry was doing in Cheetham Road? A restricted area, no heavy vehicles?
They're all told to stick by the rules. I don't condone breaking the law.
What, you mean to tell me your company doesn't run an incentive scheme for delivering on time?
What are you suggesting, Sergeant?
Nothing. Just wondering why the driver removed the taco disc. What he was doing in a route that was clearly dangerous.
I think perhaps we should leave it there. I think we've been as helpful as we can.
Sarge.
Could you just hold on a sec, please?
Dave.
Sarge, what's...
Hey.
William Bell, failing to stop, drink drive, two counts, lost his licence for both, only that's not the end of it. Last year, 3 months for driving while disqualified. He's banned for 5 years.
Not likely to have an HGV licence, then. Is that the driver?
Well, yeah, but I thought the driver's name was Lawson.
Didn't we all?
Right, I got this out as well, Sarge. The real Daniel Lawson. Suspected arson of his own haulage company. Nothing proved.
But the insurance didn't cough up, no.
Do you want me to get hold of Inspector Monroe?
Yeah, and tell Sergeant Cry I want Mrs. Lawson picking up. I think she's got some explaining to do.
Right.
Sarge, what the hell's going on here?
The driver was William Bell, not Lawson. Someone's running a dodgy scam supplying drivers. Drew's in on it. It's a question of who else.
Right. Sorry to keep you, gentlemen. Little problems come up. Hopefully Mr. Drew can help us.
To do with the incident, Sergeant?
Yeah. We have a problem identifying the dead driver.
Dead?
I thought that was all clear. I can't see that my client can do any more.
You are still keen to help us, Mr. Drew?
William Bell was the driver tonight, not Lawson. Isn't that right, Mr. Drew?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Well, he said his name was Lawson. I just took him on as a one-off.
No. There was a break-in at your office tonight. Someone was very interested in your job sheets going back a few years. I had a little look at them.
Would you mind explaining?
There are loads of jobs marked down to a Dan Lawson. He's quite a regular. In fact, on a couple of occasions, it's hard to see how he finished one trip before starting another. Perhaps you can explain.
I need time to think.
I think I'd like to talk to my client, Sergeant.
Yeah. You do that.
Are you sure about this, Sergeant? We've only just dropped her off.
Sergeant Boyden would like Mrs. Lawson brought in, June. Apart from that, you know as much as I do.
Mrs. Lawson? Mrs. Lawson? Mrs. Lawson? It's WPC Acklin. Are you here?
June.
Mrs. Lawson?
I thought you might come back.
Right. Well, I've had a word with me solicitor, and I'm ready to help.
Go on.
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? I was conned. I employed a driver who wasn't who he said he was.
Well, what have we got here? We've got a medical certificate in the name of Daniel Lawson. It describes him as a fit man in his 40s. That hardly matches the description of the man we now know to be William Bell.
Don't tell me you employed him with your eyes closed.
Sergeant, if Mr. Bell has been guilty of fraud, has driven under a false identity, I can't see that this implicates my client in any way.
No, but your client knows the real Dan Lawson. He was a rival haulier before he went out of business. Isn't that right, Mr. Drew?
I still don't see that that implicates my client in any way. Are you charging Mr. Drew with a criminal offence?
No, but we will be submitting a report to the Health and Safety Executive. What have we got so far, Dave?
No markings on a dangerous vehicle, no trem card to identify the chemical.
And that's just for starters. I doubt it was an ADR certificate for that load, or that the driver was properly trained.
They'd have a field day.
Think you'll have much of a yard left when they're through with you? You want to start doing yourself a favour.
Aye, aye, okay. Okay. I employ a few drivers full-time. The rest I get in when the work's there.
Go on.
I deal through an agency. They send the drivers along to me with the paperwork, licences, medical certificates.
And it never occurred to you that the paperwork didn't match the driver in front of you?
Once or twice.
Is that all? There are other names that crop up on those sheets all the time apart from Dan Lawson. On one sheet, there are two drivers with the same name either end of the country.
How'd you manage that? Someone must have got slack.
This wasn't a one-off. That agency was sending you unfit drivers day in, day out, and you were turning a blind eye. You were filing the false paperwork and forgetting about it.
You get busy. You get a job on, either you do it, accept the driver you've got, Oh, yeah, he'd lose it.
And that's the bottom line, yeah? Hmm? Profit. A man died tonight, Mr. Drew. He had a serious drink problem. Were you aware of that?
No.
No. No, but you put him behind the wheel of a dangerous vehicle.
Let's get back to Dan Lawson, the real one. Know him well?
Yeah, we'll go way back.
What about more recent?
He used to drive for us. After his firm got...
Is that when he torched his own yard? Got into trouble, took the easy way out? Well?
That's Dan's answered everything, cut and run. He was in his house when you picked her dead up to take her to the hospital. Straight on the blower to me. Wanted us to torch me office. Get shot at the fails.
But you wouldn't. So we tried another way, the break-in.
Sounds about right.
It's one thing I don't understand. The way you're painting Dan Lawson, he seems like a panicker, not too bright. Whoever sorted this scam knew what they were doing.
So?
So I don't know how he lasted so long. He doesn't sound capable.
Who said he did? Who said it was him?
Right, come here.
How did they get hold of the false paperwork in the first place?
Well, either Lawson or another fit driver would do the medical. They duplicate the HGV licence and use that to get a disqualified driver the work.
For a tidy rake off themselves?
Quite a racket, according to their files. At least a dozen sets of papers, four or five drivers working under each name.
Oh, thanks, June. Mrs. Lawson, earlier tonight you identified a body as being that of your husband, Daniel Lawson. That was a lie, wasn't it?
Yes.
Who was the dead man?
I'm not sure. My husband called him Billy.
William Bell.
So, why did you identify this man as your husband? Were you aware that William Bell was driving under the guise of your husband?
That he got the job with a false medical certificate in your husband's name?
I guessed that Dan was up to something. I didn't know what.
Are you telling us you had no knowledge of this?
That's right.
Well, we've heard different, Mrs. Lawson.
Our information is that you're running an agency, supplying unfit drivers to haulage companies. Whose idea was that? Yours? Your husband's?
No. Dan's too much of a loser. Wouldn't have the nous, would he?
Tell us about his yard.
That was his, ask him.
I'm asking you. Husband and wife, you must have shared things.
Yeah, I was in trouble going to the wall. Did he tell you about it? Or did he keep pretending?
Dan never admits anything, even to himself. Until it's too late.
And then he panicked. Did he also tell you he planned to torch his own lorries? Didn't think so.
Where is your husband, Mrs. Lawson?
Gone.
Where?
I don't know. I got back. The car had gone. He'd taken some clothes.
He's taken off. Left you to deal with it all.
Wouldn't be the first time.
No.
When the yard was going down, it was, don't worry, I'll sort it. Didn't want me to interfere, you see. Even hid the books from me.
And when he does sort it, he makes things worse. Did you get your insurance money, Mrs. Lawson?
They invited us to sue them for the money. Dan was all set on it.
But you knew you didn't have a case. The more that came out in court, the more you had to lose.
How did Dan cope with that?
Same way as he copes with everything. Shoves his head in the sand.
Where did you find the drivers?
It wasn't hard. First we used the blokes that Dan had driven with, you know. Ones who'd lost their license.
For a good reason, probably.
And then things got out of hand. Started using blokes that Dan had met at the DSS, snooker hall, and...
To fill the demand.
Mrs. Lawson, did it ever occur to you that what you were doing was wrong? The bigger surprise tonight is there weren't more casualties. You don't give a toss, do you? You're not even sorry for what you did.
What good would that do?
It's gotta be sick, isn't it? You're standing over a dead body making out it's your husband.
Yeah, and it takes all sorts.
Number three, isn't it?
Yes.
There we are.
There's no rush. I don't think Mrs. Bell's gonna be very pleased to see us.
I thought he was my Billy.
Mrs. Bell?
Yeah?
We're from Sunhill Police. Do you think we could come in, please?
Why? What is it?
It's about your husband.
What?
It's not something we can discuss on the doorstep. Can we come in?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Tonight you identified the body of William Bell as your husband. How long would you have gone on pretending? How long before you told Mrs. Bell that her husband was dead? That you'd buried him in her place?
Inspector Munro is asking why you kept her in the dark.
Okay, Mrs. Lawson. Sergeant Boyden will want to take a full statement. Then you're free to go.
Sir?
I know, but what can we do wrong, Matthew? Doesn't matter what we think. Fact is, she's going to get away with it.
She killed a man. Good ass. Played the widow, identified the wrong body.
So, take a statement, submit it. Obstructing a coroner, perverting the course of justice? You can try for it if you want. Only it won't go the distance. We both know that.
I'd better get dressed.
Right. Come on, there's no hurry. Sit back down, come on.
Yeah, that's right.
All right. I'll put the kettle on you.
Yeah. Is there somebody that we can call? I mean, a friend who can come with you? Somebody from the family, perhaps?
There's nobody. You were with Billy when he died.
Yes. Your husband was unconscious most of the time. He was in no pain.
Shouldn't have been driving that lorry, should he?
No. No, Mrs. Bell. He shouldn't.
Tried to stop drinking, but he just couldn't. He was never unkind to me. He was a good man. I mean, just because you go wrong once, it doesn't mean to say you're a bad person. I wish it could have got to me in time. I'd have liked to have been there. Just to say goodbye.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Don't thank me, Mrs. Lawson. If it was down to me, I'd throw the lot at you. Anything I could find legit and then some.
What? Twist the rules? Make them work in your favour like I did?
Mm. I'll be fine from here, Sergeant.
Yeah. Go carefully.